Hi, Walnut Tree. It's me, Laz. Funny, as I get the sacral urge to come live, the neighbour starts mowing the lawns. So I apologise for the sound if you cannot hear me very well, but I felt really like I needed to share my voice with you. Sorry, I don't like the glare. So if you're here, say hello, and if you're on the replay, hashtag Walnut Wednesday so I can say hello to you later. I wanted to share how what I am feeling, and it needs to come out with my voice. And I've been having, as you know, if you caught my last live video with you, and I was telling you how I've just had like a full week. So this was like last week or the week before, of just bully demon and imposter syndrome and feeling so unseen, and like my voice doesn't matter, and all these feelings. And it hasn't gone away. I'm kind of like in this lull that's sort of been going on a lot longer than what I've normally experienced. And I was talking with Kate about it this morning, and only to find that, you know, she's in a sort of similar place, which kind of gave me the motivation to come in and talk to you, Walnut, and tell you how I'm feeling, because it just reaffirmed to me that, you know, it might not just be me that is feeling this way, and that might need to feel this and not feel so alone in this. So I'm really coming to you, Walnut, just to, if you are feeling in this way, to give you some permission to have the feeling, and kind of just tell you what is kind of sort of going on for me. But the only way I can really describe it is the German word Weltschmerz, which basically, if you literally translate it, is world pain. But it kind of is like this feeling of just melancholy. And I'm laughing because it's so like, it's so weird, but I just feel a disappointment in humanity. And I'm not expressing myself to start opinions on politics or argue with anyone. I ask, please, if it's anything to do with that, I'm not in a mental capacity to have a discussion on it at the moment. But nor am I ever, really. I'm not a very watching the news politics person, but I am looking at my social media, I'm looking at the tiny snips of news that I do watch, it's not a lot, and I feel like everyone, I feel like it's just arguments. I don't feel or see constructive discussions. I see heavy opinions, and I see aggression. I see a lot of stuff, and it's like building that with, I'm getting emotional, adding that to just my normal Shark Tank polarity in life, with a couple of other things that go on, all the way to how I'm noticing how I respond to something versus how my partner responds to something, and how like suppressed as a woman I am, and stuff like that, is just like, it's all building into one feeling of Weltschmerz, and I can't kick it and I can't shake it. Let me know if you're resonating with this. If you don't, Walnut, and if you think I'm just being such a cow, feel free to like not watch, leave the group if you want to, if you're not agreeing or feeling like this is a good enough, not good enough, feeling like a good conversational space for you. But in talking to Kate and her realizing, oh my gosh, yes, I have this in the same way, I have this in the same way, we talked about a little bit more personal stuff, I just wanted to come on and sort of give you that permission, Walnut, that it is okay to not feel okay. And sometimes you just want the world to just sort of stop so you can just kind of either catch up or I don't know. I don't even know what I'm craving, Walnut. I just feel extremely tired, and I've got a couple of other things to share, like I have dread, leftover dread from the weekend. I feel insanely drained and tired, and it's like my open emotional center, my empathy levels, they're just in complete overdrive because there's so many feelings being felt all around me that I'm just sucking them all in and just amplifying them out within my body. It's like my body can't actually hold all of these emotions that aren't actually mine to like cling on to. Some of them are, but a lot of them are just external, you know, open emotional center feels, where I just feel like I am radiating or bubbling up all this stuff, and I don't really know where to put it. I don't really know where to express myself, and it's overwhelming me, and it's making me so tired. So I just wanted to sort of like share where I was at, and I did that post last night about how to last night I was gonna wallow and still sit in the stinky shit. If you want to know more about like the pooey analogies, just scroll down to my last live video where I kind of like talked about something that Kate Decker raised about sitting in shit, and you get to a point and it just starts to smell too bad, so you like get up and out, get out of it. For me, it's just it's ongoing at the minute. So I just wanted to share that I haven't been in a place like this before, and this is quite a new feeling of overwhelm and Weltschmerz and melancholy and despair. So I'm just kind of navigating through that for myself at the moment. I'll think about it a bit more thoroughly and do a podcast episode on that. Just so when I get more clear on what it is I'm actually feeling and how I'm planning to go about it. But I do want to kind of bring back the excitement of the book and things like that. So I will try and plan for this weekend. We'll have a live little party and things like that. But Walnut, I can't sit in my happiness and excitement for my creation when I'm feeling this way. So I'm just coming on to be honest with you, I suppose, and tell you about my Weltschmerz without being specific at all. So if you do have a suffering from a little bit of Weltschmerz yourself, feeling a bit like a butthole or just even overwhelmed, not necessarily with society or humanity, but just with life in general, please know that you're not alone and you're not by yourself. And I will work out what I'm doing and how I'm navigating through this and drop a podcast episode so we can discuss it further. But please know that you're always welcome in this space to ask for help, share your voice, express yourself, or just celebrate that you brushed your teeth today. I had a biscuit for breakfast, so, you know, so we're here for you, and I am feeling the feels right next to you. So we've got this, Walnut, we've got this, and I just wanted to come on and share my voice. So thank you for listening to my express, and I hope that... No, I was going to say, I hope you have a good day. I don't know if you're having a good day or not. I don't even know what I hope. I'm so overwhelmed. So just thank you for listening. Thank you for holding this little space for me. Lulu said, I definitely relate to the feels of overwhelm, especially that feeling of wanting the world to stop for a moment so I can catch my breath. Yeah, it kind of feels like, you know, when you're grieving a little bit, grief kind of makes you feel that way, where you just want everything to just go on pause so you can just process the things. But at this point, it's not like in my grief journey where I needed to process things and I was kind of in shock. At the moment, I'm overstimulated in all the different areas. I don't know, you know, what I think or what my opinion is, and I'm just feeling. I feel like I'm just feeling and amplifying all these emotions and versus what's on my newsfeed to what's in my mind and all these things. So I think I almost need to have like a social media, not even a declutter, just like a not really looking at it. But I also don't want to delete my things at the same time. So it's such such a weird time. But what I wanted to say is I'm with you if you're feeling this. I'm right next to you. We've got this. We will get through it eventually, and I'll keep you posted as I sort of navigate through. But the celebration, I'm thinking this weekend, so kind of like keep your eyes peeled about this weekend, but it really just depends on if my Weltschmerz kind of lifts a little bit. Yeah, and we'll go from there. So I'll keep you posted, keep in touch, let me know your feels, and let me know if you brushed your teeth today, if you got out of bed, or if you did one thing that's like easy but was hard. I believe in you. I believe you can do the things. And I think that you're beautiful, you're sexy, and you're delicious. And you're a wonderful walnut who, despite is feeling the feels, has got this somehow. I don't know how, but you do. So I'll talk to you soon, and I'll keep you posted, and thank you for holding the space and for listening.